our God is alive, and a man shall not live from bread alone, but from every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. And the children of Israel, they had to get up early in the morning when they were in the wilderness, and they had to go and pick up their manna before the sun came up. When the sun came up and they did not pick up their manna, then the manna disappeared, and they wouldn't have bread for the day. You know, and the Lord is also saying to us, we must get up early, and we must pick up that manna. The Lord wakes us up at night, and then we get up and we pray, and He gives us our manna, gives us our word. A man will not live from bread alone, but from every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. And that is why we must hear from Jesus Christ. That is what it is about to be a Christian. Now tonight I want to talk about false Christians. This whole world is full of false Christians. Now what is a Christian? A Christian is a follower of Jesus Christ. He does not belong to a church or to a group or to a denomination, or he does not follow after people. He's a follower of Jesus. Now, if we are not individually following after Jesus, then we are fakes. Many people are religious. They are Bible believers, and they read the Bible, and they have their doctrines, and they follow after the Bible. They're not following Jesus. A lot of people belong to a church. They are Methodists and Baptists and Catholics and all those mean things, you know. Because all those churches are controlled by demons. Because it's not Jesus guiding them. It's religious demons. If you are a Christian, a real child of God, then you follow Jesus. It doesn't matter whether anybody comes along. You follow Jesus. You don't belong to a group. You belong to Jesus. You follow Him. You listen to Him. Your business is with Jesus. He is your life. Not with anybody else. And whether you are alone, or whether you are with people, or whether you are in town, or at the shopping mall, or whether you're driving in a car, or whatever you're doing, you follow Jesus. Your business is with Jesus. Your thoughts, your mind, everything is Jesus. If anything else takes your attention, and if you follow after anything else or anybody else, any person, then you're not a follower of Jesus. Some people follow after their husbands. And some men, they follow after their wives. Some children follow after their parents. They belong to the church of their daddy, their mommy. They were brought up in the church. Some people follow after the pastor. Some people are Calvinists. And so they go along. If you are anything but a disciple of Jesus Christ, then you're a fake. Then you're a fake. If you get your wisdom and your guidance from anybody but Jesus, even if you get your guidance from the Bible, you've got a problem. Because then you are not a follower of Jesus. Jesus says, "My sheep listen to my voice and they follow me." Now, a lot of people say the Lord is not talking to them. So obviously, either they've never heard the voice of the Lord or they've never met Him. If the Lord is not speaking to you, and you don't know Him. Or maybe you've got sin in your life. But if you are following Jesus, then you need to hear His voice. You need to pray until He reveals Himself to you. You need to cry out to Jesus. That's what it is about. It's not about King James or NIV or whatever you call it. Those are not, if you're following after those things and if you are following after doctrines, you're not busy with Jesus. If your priority is going to church, then you're not following Jesus. Your priority must be Jesus Christ. Even when you're alone. Now, a lot of people say they need fellowship. You know, they need Christian friends. So they're going after people. And their faith depends on other people. On their friendship, and on their club membership, church club. If we are hanging on anything else or hanging off anything else but Jesus Christ, then we are fakes. Because Jesus only said one thing. He said, follow me. And He said, anyone who puts his hand to the plow and looks back is not worthy of me. So if you follow Jesus, you follow Jesus. It doesn't matter whether your mommy or your daddy or your wife or husband is coming along, you follow Jesus. And that is what it is about. Now a lot of people don't know what it means to follow Jesus because there are so many lies going on. You know, people say they're following Jesus, but they don't even know Jesus. They call themselves good Christians, but they don't even know about discipleship. There's only one way, friends. There's only one truth. A lot of people say the Bible is the truth. Now, I'm not saying the Bible is the lie. The Bible says Jesus Christ is the way, is the life, and is the truth. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says Jesus Christ is the Word of God. John chapter 1 verse 1 says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And verse 14 he says, and the Word became flesh, Jesus Christ. Friends, that is the Word in which we believe. That is the Word which we have to hear. That is the Word that we've got to follow. To be real Christians, to be real disciples of Jesus Christ, to be part of the kingdom of God. Then our desire, our business is following Jesus. That's all we're about. It is about one thing only, and that is, Lord, are you pleased with me? Lord Jesus, please speak to me. Lord, let your Spirit speak to me. And you pray until God speaks to you. That's what it is about. And if the Lord doesn't speak to you, you find out why. You say, Lord, why are you not speaking to me? And He'll tell you quickly. This week the Lord was one day not speaking to me. And then I went, I prayed, I said, Lord, why are you not speaking to me? He said to me, there's something that you didn't tell your wife. You tell her, then I'll speak to you. You speak the truth to each other. You speak the truth to your wife, then I'll speak to you. You see, God wants truth. He wants obedience. And if we disobey the Lord, immediately He stops speaking to us. A lot of people have never heard the Lord. A lot of people heard the Lord a long time ago. And He's not speaking to them anymore, but they're not worried about that. Because they believe. They believe they are saved. Jesus didn't tell anybody you are saved. He said, follow me. He said, endure until the end. They said to him, Lord, are those who are being saved, are they few? Not those who are saved, those who are being saved, are they few? And he said to them, many, I say to you, will try hard and will not be able. He says, strive to enter the narrow gate, because many will. Many will try very hard and they will not be able. Now, a lot of believers are not trying very hard. They tell you they cannot stop sinning. Now, if you're still battling to stop sinning, you cannot be following Jesus. You know, you need to make up your mind to stop sinning before you can follow Jesus. A lot of people have got a hard time to get baptized, to go through the water. You cannot be following Jesus. If you didn't go through the water, how can you follow Jesus? A lot of people are slandering other people. They're not following Jesus. The Holy Spirit did not guide them into attacking a brother and a sister. A lot of people are busy with religion. They're debating the Bible, scriptures, putting up big religious fights. They're not following Jesus. They are fakes. They are deceived themselves. They're deceiving other people. A lot of people, they are fighting about the things like the Hebrew names of the Lord. They're not led by the Spirit. The Lord Jesus didn't tell him to fight about those things. He said, follow me. The words of our Lord are clear, simple, plain and simple. Those people who heard the Lord, they wrote his words down, some of the words he spoke in the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke and John. And the Holy Spirit that Jesus puts in us, that he gives in us, will remind us of the words of Jesus, even if you've never heard them, even if you've never read them, he will speak the same to you. If you listen, but you see, a lot of people are not following Jesus. The world is full of fakes, fake Christians. Now, and the sad thing about it is they will stand before Jesus and say, Lord, we were saved. In that church, I put up my hand and I said the sinner's prayer and I was saved. The Lord says, I don't know you. See, yes, Lord, and we went to church and we had a good time there. We worked for you. We built a big church. And even went on mission trips. The Lord says, I didn't send you. I called you. I said to you, follow me. You were busy following people. You were busy reading, studying, going to Bible school. You were doing what pleased you. I called you. You didn't come. I said, follow me. You didn't follow me. I said, come here, spend time with me. Listen. The Lord will say, I put obstacles in your way to call you, to bring you closer to me. I said, come here, I want to talk to you. You wouldn't come. Friends, if we are not following Jesus Christ, then we got a problem. Then we are fake Christians. A Christian, as a disciple, is a follower of Jesus, is led by the Holy Spirit of God. And if you don't have the Holy Spirit, you've got a problem. Because then you cannot be following the Lord. A lot of people don't want the Holy Spirit. They've got a holy Bible. Nobody ever said it's holy. It's the scriptures. You've got to follow holy Jesus. And you've got to be holy yourself. And you have got to be an epistle written to this world. You have got to be holy. The world has got to see Jesus in you. And in me. That is where the world must see Jesus Christ is in us. We are the light of the world. We are put here for a purpose to shine our light. This world is darkness, friends, and it's getting darker and darker because the Christians are fake. They're not following Jesus. They got no light in them. They are darkness. They're busy with the wrong things. They're busy with themselves. They're busy with their own plans. A lot of people think they can serve God their way. You know, they make their own mission trip. They go build their own churches. They go and do their own thing. Jesus said, you go over land and sea to make one convert. And when you've made him, you make him double as ripe for hell as you are yourselves. Because they fill these people with knowledge and their doctrines, but they don't know Jesus. They don't take them to Jesus. You see, friends, if we are disciples of Jesus Christ, then we don't have followers. We take people to Jesus. We take a man to the Lord and we put his hand in his hand and he follows Jesus. He doesn't follow us. Because Jesus is the way and the truth and the life. And his words are eternal life to those who listen to him and who follow him. Yes, they are baby believers. They are baby disciples. And we've got to feed them. But you can only feed them if you have received from the Lord. You cannot feed them junk food. You cannot feed them canned food. You must feed them with what the Holy Spirit has given you to give to them. When the Lord called Peter, he said, you love me. He says, yes, Lord, you know I love you. He says, Peter, feed my sheep. He asked him three times. He said to him, do you love me? And Peter got very sad. He said, tend my sheep, tend my lambs. Friends, that is our job, is to tend the lambs, to take them to Jesus, to feed them with the food that he gives us, but they are his lambs. They are not our lambs. You know, these churches, they steal each other's sheep, but because it's their sheep. They're not following Jesus. They belong to that church. And are disciples of Christ. Do you know any disciples? Do you know any people who really follow Jesus? The church cannot make disciples. They make churches. They make people that belong to the church. They make fake and false Christians. They're not followers of Christ. A Christian is a follower of Jesus Christ. He listens to the Holy Spirit of God. He waits on the Lord. He prays, he listens. He goes where the Lord sends him. Lord Jesus said to Nicodemus, he said that a one who is born again, he's like a wind. You don't know where he's coming from or where he's going. Why is it? It's because he is driven by the Spirit of God. He's led by the Spirit of God. He's got no plans. He is part of God's plan. He's doing what God tells him to do. He is the light of the world. He's got light in him. He's bearing fruit. Because he is grafted into the vine. Jesus said, without me, you can do nothing. Yes, churches, they build churches. They build buildings. They build their own little mansions. They build their own empires in this world. They make themselves a big following, mega churches, mega deceptions. But they're not Christians, none of them, not one of them. They're all deceived, they are following after people, they are hanging on the lips of people. I just want to hear, what is this guy going to say? It's a lonely road, friends. You cannot walk that road and still be following anybody else. You cannot be going after your buddies. You don't join a group. You go where Jesus sends you. He might send you one, two, or whatever. But He is using you according to His plan. We don't have followers. My wife and me, we just go where the Lord tells us. We are here to take you to Jesus. We are here to make disciples of Christ. And we ourselves are disciples. We don't have no plan. We don't have no 5-year plan, a 1-year plan, a 1-day plan. I've got no plans. We follow the Holy Spirit. God has got the plan. He knows. He knows what we're going to do tomorrow. He knows if we'll be here. I don't know. It's not my business. Jesus said, don't worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will have enough of its own trouble. He says we must keep our eyes on Him. Friends, if we do not keep our eyes on Jesus, and if we do not pray, and pray and pray until you hear from the Lord, how can you follow Him? If you've got no relationship with Jesus, how can you be a disciple? If the only thing you got is your Bible, then you got nothing. You need the Holy Spirit. You need the Spirit of God guiding you. You got to be listening, waiting on Him, doing what He tells you to do, going where He sends you to go. Or else, you cannot bear fruit. If you're not in Christ, how can you do the works of Christ? Jesus said, the works that I did, you will do and greater. Because I go to my Father. Friends, that is what He has called us for. Why are we not seeing those things happening? It's because there are no disciples. So our world is full of fake Christians. People who follow their own mind. They got their own versions of the Bible. They got their own ideas. They got their own little church. They got their own little group. And they occupy themselves with their own mind. And with the books and the readings and of other people. If that book that you're reading does not make you call out to Jesus and cry out to Him, throw it away. Get on your knees and call out to Jesus. If the person that you are listening to does not make you call out to the Lord and go to Him, then that person is a deceiver. He's not a follower of Jesus himself. I'm telling you tonight, dear friends, go to Jesus. Go on your knees and cry out to the Lord. Say, Lord, I want to hear You. Lord Jesus, I want my relationship with Thee to be real. If you don't have that desire, friend, you don't have a desire or a hope on eternal life. Jesus Christ is our life. If you're not connected to Him, you've got a problem. People are worried if their internet is down. They are worried if their cell phone connection is dead. But they're not worried about hearing the Lord. They're worried if people reject Him. If they don't have a church. But they're not worried about not having Jesus Christ because they never had Him. They've never been taught to have Jesus. They've never been taught to pray until they get through, until the Holy Spirit speaks to them. They've never been taught to do that. And that is what we are here to teach you, friends. Is go to Jesus. Go cry out to the living God. How can people take others to Jesus if they themselves do not know Jesus? They are deceived. They are followers of men. Friends, this world is full of fake Christians. But you know, it's wonderful that the Lord is calling us. He sent us His Holy Spirit. And He's beckoning each and every person here. He says, come to Me. Come closer to Me. Come listen. He's not sending you to another person to go and listen to that person's wisdoms. He hasn't appointed some people who are now the prophets and the spokesmen, and now you've got to go to those people and they will tell you what God says. No. No, He says, I will write My laws in your heart. He says, I will speak to you in your ear. I will tell you to turn to the right or to the left. He is Emmanuel, he is God with you. He says, I will live amongst them and be in them. The Lord Jesus has made his spirit dwell in us. But we got to listen, friends. We've got to be led by the Spirit of God. Like Paul said, he said, those who are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. He said that, Romans 8:14. He also said, if you do not have the Spirit of Christ, you don't belong to him. And that is what he gives you. When you come to him, you say, Lord, I want to follow you. He says, go clean up your life. Repent. Get rid of your sin. And then I will come and live in you. Be separate. And I will be a father to you, and you will be sons and daughters to me. Now people don't want to stop sinning. They say, I can't stop sinning. I cannot switch off the television, you know. I cannot get rid of my Xbox. They don't want to. And they don't have Jesus. Friends, we've got to separate ourselves unto the Lord. And we've got to seek him until we find him. We've got to cry out to him and pray. This generation is educated. They got Bibles. And they got opinions. And nowadays, children can't even read anymore. They just watch pictures. People can't spell. They can't write. It's sad. What is important, friends, is that we listen to the Holy Spirit of God. That we be connected to Jesus Christ. That we have the bread of life every day. That we hear from the Lord. Say, Lord Jesus, I need bread from thee today, Lord. Not only for myself, but to feed the sheep. Lord, I need to know what I have to do for thy kingdom today. Because I'm here to work. People say, I don't want to work. It's a works gospel. It is a works gospel. It's a gospel of you stop doing your own works. You rest of your own works. You stop going after your own desires and after your own plans. You rest of that. But you work for the kingdom of God. Because you come into full-time employment. And you work until the very end. Every day. Every day is Jesus' day. There's no time out. There's no day off. There's no time that you use for yourself. There's no holiday time and all that nonsense. You belong to the kingdom of God. You are a slave. You are a willful slave, a bond slave to Jesus Christ. You've given up your right to yourself. You've given up your right to your opinion. You've given up your First Amendment rights and all the other rights that people talk about. You give up your patriotism and your country and all of those things. You belong to Jesus. And you do his will. You follow him. You don't have an opinion. You ask him his guidance and you follow his guidance. You don't worry about protecting yourself and buying yourself a gun and fighting your own battles. You belong to him. If he wants to, he will protect you. But you are here to do the will of God. You're not here to fight for your country, to fight for yourself. He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. Why is it? Because he has prepared works for us to do. And he's calling us. He says, hey, I got a plan for you. I want to use you in my kingdom. Forsake your own ways. Come here. Repentance does not just mean to stop sinning. It doesn't just mean how you stop cussing and you stop doing a few other things, and now you just live holy and you sit there and wait for Jesus to come. No! You follow him. You go after him. You follow him every day. He said, you deny yourself. You pick up your cross and you follow him. You've got to be working every day. You've got to be doing the will of the Father. You've got to be led by the Holy Spirit. You've got to be in Christ. You've got to be working the plan of God. But if you're not praying, if you're not waiting on the Lord, if you're not making yourself available, if you have not turned away from doing your own thing, how can you be following Jesus Christ? You're just a fake Christian. And friends, a lot of people say, now I'm gonna leave everything. I'm gonna follow the Lord. Yes. Where to? What did he tell you? When did he tell you to leave your job? Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. Right where you are. The way he called you. A lot of people say, now the wife is not good anymore. No, man, this wife is... she's a heathen. She's a Gentile, you know. You know, this marriage that I got into was before I knew Jesus. Yes? And that promise that you made before God? Every promise we made is before God. He says, this I have against you. The woman of your youth. You've dealt treacherously with her. How many promises have people not made and broken? And they made them before God. They've sworn them before God. And they've broken them. And now God is destroying the works of their hands because they have sworn to God and before God, I will do this and I will do that, and they didn't do it. And now they cannot understand why their whole life is falling to pieces. Because God says, you made a promise before me and you're not keeping it. Now what's your problem? If you've made a promise like that, and if you've broken it, go talk to Jesus. Go talk to the Lord. Only he can help you remedy that, friends. I made a promise to the Lord. He made me make good on the promise. God will deal harshly with us because he requires of us that we be holy. That we be faithful, that we be dependable, that we be obedient. He does not work soft with his children. He does not spoil them. He treats them extremely harsh. God treats me harshly, friends. If I disobey him, he chastises me severely. But I thank him for it. I thank him for it because I'm his child. That is the privilege of being a child of God. A son of God is you get a hiding, man. You get corrected. Why is that? So that we can share in his holiness. Can people see Jesus in us? Does the world see the Lord in us? Or are we just like the rest? Procrastinators. Gutless. Going along with everything, tolerating anything, using discretion. The Holy Spirit of God has got no discretion, friends. There's only one way, and that's the right way, and it's God's way. There is no other way. Jesus is the way, and you obey him, and you do his will, and finish. There are no two ways about it. There are no excuses. All that God requires of us is obedience. That's all. Just do what the Lord says. And things will be well with you. And our people, you know, they got an opinion. God's not interested in your opinion. He says, come here, follow me. I tell you what to do. And if you don't want to do it, then you're not part of my house. But if you're my child, I'm going to beat you. I'm going to fix you up. And in the end, if you don't listen, I'm going to cut you off. But there's only one way, and that is you're going to come right to you, or I'm going to kick you out. Friends, God loves us, and he cares for us. But there's only one way, and that's God's way. And if you follow Jesus Christ, you walk with him, even if you walk alone. So what? You're never alone, you're walking with Jesus. But I'll tell you one thing, you walk with Jesus, people will be scared of you. They will not be wanting to walk with you. That's how you're crazy. They will not do what you do because you're doing the will of God and they hate it. They will not want to live the way that you live. Because God's ways are not our ways. And friends, if we walk God's ways, we live in the presence of God and we have the peace of God and we do the works of God. And then He can work through us and He can use us, because then we are instruments in the hand of God. But it's not an easy road. It's not for many people. There are not many disciples. Do you know disciples? I don't know many. I can assure you that. There's only one way, and it's God's way, and it's a narrow way, and it's a tough way. And either you walk that way or you out. Jesus says, if you look back, you can go. He's not begging us to follow Him. You know, when the disciples at one stage, they said, Lord, this word you're speaking now is very hard. Go read John chapter 6. When He said, if you do not eat my body and drink my blood, you have no part in me. If you don't eat the bread of life, if you do not take the words of Jesus as He gives them to you, His hard words, if you don't want that, if you cannot stomach it, He says, well, you can go. I said, Lord, this is a hard word. Who can stand it? And many of His disciples left Him. And then He said to the 12, and don't you also want to go? Peter said to Him, Lord, where can we go? You have the words of eternal life. Friends, those are the words of eternal life. It's the words of Jesus. The words that He will speak to you. And you can take it or you can leave it. And if you don't want it, you can go. He won't hold you back. But you will lose for eternity. It's not an easy road. It's a narrow road, friends, and very few people will walk it. Very few people will find that narrow door. But either we walk the road and we are Christians, we are followers of Jesus Christ, or we are just deceiving ourselves. The question that I have to ask myself is, am I following Jesus? Lord, am I doing Your will now? Lord, am I pleasing to You? Lord, please show me the way. Every day. Every day. Every day. You cannot have time out for one day. You can be driving your car on that freeway all the time. You start looking around. You leave the road. And you can have a fatal accident. You've got to keep your eyes on the road. You've got to keep your eyes on Jesus. You've got to stay focused on Him. You've got to be obedient every day. You cannot disobey Him. Follow Him the day you like. Or say, Lord, today I want to do this and that for You. Tomorrow I want to go do that. I've got a holiday plan. I picked up this nice holiday somewhere, Cancun or wherever. No, friend. We are in full-time duty of the kingdom of God, or we are not. We've got to make up our mind. And if Jesus tells you to go to Cancun, go there. But please make sure that He sent you. It is about the kingdom of God, or it's about me, friends. You cannot be a follower of Jesus part-time. It is a full-time occupation. You go where the Lord sends you. You do what He tells you. And you don't do anything unless He tells you. You ask His direction and His wisdom in everything. People say to me, well, I guess, you know, you don't need to take everything to the Lord. So which you don't want to take to the Lord? Which is private? Which is your business? If you're carrying a cross, you're carrying a cross. If you're a disciple of Jesus, you follow Him every day. You do what He tells you to do. And if you don't want to do it, you can go. Friends, that is what it means to be a Christian, a follower of Jesus Christ. It is 100% commitment to Jesus. And Jesus is your life. He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all the other things will be added unto you. And Jesus becomes your life. Is it easy? No, it's not. It's really impossible. It's really impossible. But that is what makes it so wonderful. And when things are going wrong, they're actually going right. Like Sister Valerie, They put her out of the one apartment, but God has got a better apartment for her. You say, Lord, where am I going to live? He says, don't worry, I got a nice place for you. Don't worry, I got the plan. I'm already ahead of you. Just keep your eyes on me. That's how God works. He says, be concerned about nothing, but let your desires become known to God with prayer and supplication and thanksgiving. And God's got the plan. Why did I have an accident? The Lord knows. He's got a plan with it. Brother Dennis had an accident. We don't know why. But God knows. He says, not an hair of our head falls on the ground without God knowing it. He says, the hair on our head, the very hairs on our head are counted. He knows about it. He's got a plan with it. We've got to submit and say, Lord, thank you. I thank you, Lord Jesus. You're in control of my life. And if you want to be saying something to me, Lord, then I'm listening. But I'm following Jesus. He's my life. Friends, the Lord loves us. He cares for us. He loved us so much that He died on Calvary for you and for me. And that is why we've got to die to me, and to my desires, and for the things that I would rather do. And I submit to Jesus. Come to Him, I say, Lord, I want to do Your will. Not what I want anymore. But now I'm doing what You want me to do. I belong to You, Lord. I'm all Yours. Put Your words in my mouth. Put Your thoughts in my mind. Guide my footsteps. I'm here for Jesus. Shine Your light through me, Lord. Let the world see that Jesus Christ is alive. Let there be light in darkness. Let there be power. Let the power of God be manifested. Let the world see that they are disciples of Christ. That the body of Christ is alive. And that we are the body of Christ in which He dwells. And through whom He works. Those who are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. The others are fake. Are we real or are we fake? Are we true followers of Jesus Christ our Lord? And that is what we've got to make sure about. Say, Lord, where do I stand tonight? If I'm not what You want me to do, show me, Lord, please. But I want to make it right before it is forever too late. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give Thee glory and honor and praises. We thank Thee, Lord, for Thy word. We thank Thee for Thy wisdom. We thank Thee, Father, for revealing Thyself to us, for calling us unto Thee, Lord, and for making us vessels of Thy honor and Thy power and Thy glory, Lord, so that Jesus Christ can be manifested in and through us to the glory of God our King and Master. We are here to glorify Thee, Lord. We are vessels of Thy honor for Thy purpose to be used for Thy kingdom, Father, and we want to be listening to Thee and want to be doing Thy will, O God. Lord, please use us, please live through us, please shine through us, Lord, and let Jesus Christ be manifested in this world, Lord. We just bring Thee glory and honor and praises, Father. Let Thy light shine, Father. O Lord, we give Thee glory and honor. We thank Thee, Lord, for this wonderful honor, Lord Jesus, for this life that has been granted unto us so that we can have life in us. And that we can bring life to this world. That we can take others and make them disciples of Christ. So that they can also serve our King and Master and be part of His mighty kingdom. We give Thee glory and honor and praises, Father. We thank Thee, Lord Jesus. May Thy name be praised for all eternity, Father. We give Thee all the glory, all the praises. We thank Thee in Jesus' precious name. Amen.